Hi, and welcome to another painting tutorial. I've got my canvas all primed and ready to go here. I've just covered it with liquid white and then just put some Prussian blue on here just to give me a background to work on. What I was going to do today, there's a lot of people asking, how to do trees, and they're struggling with doing trees and bushes and evergreens and, whatever kind of tree you're going to put in your painting. There are loads of different ways of working with trees, loads of different ways of doing it. The main thing I think people struggle with is how to load your brush, how much paint to use, and whether a paint is thin enough or thick enough to be able to do the technique. So what we're going to do, we're going to roll through various different trees. We'll do some evergreens, we'll do some bushes, we'll do some grasses, all this kind of stuff, and hopefully I'll pick up on all of the questions that people have and need answering. So to start with, up here, it's going to work a bit like the mountain workshop if you've seen me do that. I'm going to just paint trees all over this canvas. I'm not going to worry too much about it. We're going to start up here with some evergreens. All I've done on my palette, I've mixed some black, some brown, and there's a little bit of the Prussian blue in there that I use for the background. But I've got quite a lot of dark paint there, basically because I'm going to use it throughout the entirety of the painting. So if we're doing... We're going to start with some conifers up the back here, some fir trees. So we just need to put some dark colour on. So we've got our fan brush, and it's about loading paint onto the fan brush in the right way. So you want to bring the fan brush through, and you need to almost bring this to a chiselled edge. Well, not almost, you do. So pull it through the paint, both sides, then angle it downwards a bit more and go a bit lighter. And you'll end up with a chiselled edge. And you can see that on there. When I get it in line with the camera, there you can see, how much of a chiselled edge that's now got on it. I can make this way. There we go. So you can see the chiselled edge on that. Anyway, there's a huge amount of paint loaded up on that. And basically it's like sharpening a knife. The softer you go, the more of a chiselled edge you'll get there. So if we're starting with a little scene here, if we want to do the background trees, we can bring our brush in at this kind of angle and keep this upper edge of the brush perpendicular to the canvas, and we can just tap and we get the beginnings of a little line up in this corner. And if you continue tapping downwards, you can create, twist the brush over, you can create a distant line of trees here. So here comes our distant line of trees. Reload the brush. If you haven't got paint on the brush, you're not going to make any kind of mark at all. So we'll just create a distant line of trees here. And these are so far away, we're not even going to worry about detail. Keep loading the brush. Every time you load the brush, you'll get some more distinct trees. So you might want to just make them stick up a bit more than the other ones. Okay, and they can head off over here. And notice, if they get further away, you can get lighter in pressure and use less and less paint until these just disappear away in the mist. And it doesn't matter where they go, they're just off in the mist somewhere. Doesn't matter. So that creates us some background trees. And what you might want to do, once you've got some background trees, grab a 2-inch or 1-inch brush and you can come along and you can tap the bottom, just the bottom edge of these trees. And it mists them. It just creates a misty layer. So that starts misting away, and then you can just lift upwards. And this lifting upwards motion just picks up the top of these and pulls them straight up. If you pull at an angle, it's just going to look wrong. If you pull too hard, it looks like it's going to rain. It'll look like it's raining upwards, and you don't want to do that either. So that's just a simple line of trees way off in the distance there. So what if we want to bring something a bit closer? Reload your brush. And what you can do is tap and start with this little line. That's the top of our fir tree. Now, instead of having the brush angled this way and coming on here, we're going to tilt the brush horizontally and come on with that straight edge pointing straight at the canvas. And then you have a choice. You can either flick upwards, so you press and just move upwards. What you don't want to do is come straight down. If you come straight down with the same pressure all the time, this is what you get. You get just a straight up and down telegraph pole tree. So you don't want to do that. What you're aiming to do is start like that at the top, and then as you come down, zigzag backwards and forwards until the tree gets wider and wider towards the bottom. So if I do that, I can then come across and back, and across and back, and across and back, and across and back. And as I come down, I'm pressing harder and harder, but I'm always angling my brush at this direction. I'm never coming here. It's always at this direction. And down here, we might just want to put in a bit of land, just, I don't know, doesn't really matter. We'll highlight it just so you can see another way of creating some grasses. So, there's our first tree. Okay, really easy to do. Maybe there's another one, lives right next to it. Now you don't have to worry so much about this bit down the bottom. If I wanted another tree, we'll bring this one right up here. I start at the top, and because eventually these two trees will meet, I can start producing that tree. And then down here, it's almost just becoming black, so it doesn't matter. I can tap in here just to put dark onto my canvas. So now I've got two trees side by side. In some parts of the world, you get a fir tree that's completely different. You get a fir tree that has, instead of these branches going upwards, the fir tree has branches that go downwards. So you start in the same way. Tap in that top line. But instead of pushing upwards here, you push downwards. But it's exactly the same. Not quite dark enough, so if you haven't got enough paint, just go back over it. So we've now got a fir tree that hangs downwards, and we've got fir trees that spike upwards. These are more the Christmassy tide. These are sort of more, if you're doing a winter scene where snow is hanging your branches down, this is the kind of fir tree you might want to do. Now what you can do, fir trees are often sort of raggedy, they're not always good, so maybe you want one that's slightly bent over. So do your line, and then come down exactly the same way. But you might want to think, oh, okay, he had a bad year, he's trodden on or whatever. So we'll put a little bit of trunk in there, leave a gap, and then carry on. That one's gone well off at an angle, but we don't mind, doesn't matter. So now there's some branches in there, he's bent over, there's some branches in there that have fallen off, that kind of thing. So it just makes your painting a bit more interesting. Now down here, if we wanted to create grasses down the bottom here, we can take our fan brush and push straight upwards. And we're coming straight on and just flexing. You can see that flex. Look how I'm flexing. And flex upwards to create that landscape, and it just creates these grassy areas. So with that done, there are several ways of doing trunks on these. What you can do is just take your knife and just put the flat on and line upwards, and you can start just to put in trunks, and you can put trunks and bits of branches and stuff in here all over the place. That's one way of doing your trunks. Alright, that's a very quick, simple way of doing that. You don't need to worry too much about mixing any paint. You don't need to worry too much about doing anything like that. What you can do, you can also grab some titanium white. You don't need a huge amount. You're barely even going to touch the canvas doing it like this. We'll mix some of that titanium white with some of the dark colour we've got, which already had brown and blue and stuff like that in it anyway. That just gives me a grey colour. Pull it out flat. Cut a small roll of paint. And you can also come in here and just tap. And you don't want to tap all the way up. You just want to tap in a couple of places, because we're going to highlight this. And it just gives the indication that somewhere back here is the old tree trunk to these things, and you know, you might want to put them in wherever you want to put them. Doesn't matter, they can go in wherever. So now it's looking like there's quite a few trees in here. I've only painted four, but already it's starting to look like there's a lot more than four lurking around in there anyway. So how are we going to highlight these? Now in some countries, you know, you get glorious colours of evergreens, and they're not evergreen, you know, you get yellows and greens and reds all coming in when autumn is out there. So you could put some yellows in here, you could put whatever you want. The important thing to remember is obviously a thin paint will stick to a thick paint. Now most evergreens in most countries tend to be fairly dark. The nice thing with the Bob Ross system and the Bob Ross paints is the highlight colours, so in this case I've got a yellow ochre, they're mixed specifically to be thinner than your dark colours. So the dark browns, the blacks, the blues, they're all a thicker paint straight out of the tube than what you will if you start using the cad yellows and the Indian oranges and stuff like that. So the yellow ochre here is already a thin paint. So again, we're going to load this exactly the same way that we loaded it to actually produce the tree in the first place. So we want almost a chiseled head. We'll grab some of this green as well, and we'll just mix them up. So this is almost a chiseled edge again. So you can see there's a huge amount of paint on there, and it's produced a chiseled edge, and that's what you want. So again, we're going to come in with the corner of our fan brush. And these two trees that are side by side, we're going to separate. So I'm going to do the back one first. So I'm going to come in and just touch. Now if the paint doesn't come off your brush, you might need to thin it down. And you might need to thin it down with liquid clear or liquid white, or even just a dab of thinners. So you can see, just touching. I wasn't pressing hard, I wasn't flexing the bristles. I was just touching the canvas. The paint is thin enough to come off the brush anyway. If it wasn't, I might want to dip into a tiny bit of liquid white or a little bit of thinners. So this tree started at the top. I didn't reload the brush, so it's quite bright here. As it comes down, it picks up the dark colour and gets darker, darker, darker down here towards the shadows. To bring this tree forwards, I need to possibly bring some of this highlight down a bit more. So what I'm going to do is grab a little bit of white just to brighten it up just a tiny, tiny little bit. So there's not as much green in this one. Start at the top. And now I can distinctly bring that tree forwards. So you can see here, shadow puts this tree behind this tree. My light's coming from this direction, so that's where that tree is going to be. I change the flavour of the other tree that I'm now going to do, which is this one. Change the flavour of that a bit, so we'll put a bit more green in this one. And again, just touch. And highlight that tree. We'll change the flavour of the other one so you can see it will come into a bit more white. And this highlighting is exactly the same way, but remember on this one, we pushed downwards, we didn't push upwards. So there you go, highlighting these trees. Now, if you wanted to do some grass down the bottom here, load your fan brush up, quite a lot of paint. Look how much paint I'm putting on my fan brush here. I've got into that green. And again, huge amount of paint on the fan brush. And now you can come in and you can start flexing upwards here, and you can paint in these grassy areas. You want to leave some shadow. Don't want grass all over the place. You need to leave shadow so you can see where the shadows are, and you can see where your ground is being formed. There you go. You've got a little grassy knoll out there with some trees on. So that's fir trees. They're fairly easy to do. You haven't got much of a problem to worry about with those. again, it's just a question of loading the brush correctly and knowing how to load the brush correctly and then how to apply the pressure. If you wanted, you can come back in here with the corner of the knife and you can scratch in bits and bobs. And the more of these you add, you can actually start to bring pieces of land forwards. So you can bring land in, you can put twigs in here that really, there are, you know, you go off into the woods and there are always dead trees and bits sticking out all over the place. So you can scratch right through to the canvas and actually really start to almost draw in an old tree that sits here. So, that, you know, that's easy to do. You can do that just by scratching in. And it just makes something a bit more interesting. Gives people a bit more to look at in your artwork. Okay, so that's basic trees. So what about if we wanted some bushes down the bottom here? Let's go over here and we'll do some bushes. I'm going to come into our black colour. And we've got the one inch brush. Okay, got the 1 inch brush. So we're going to come into our black colour. We're going to pull it through in one direction. So we're pulling that through in one direction. You can see that there. Now as I pull through, I lift. Turn that slightly so you can see. So I pull that through and I lift. And all the time my brush is perpendicular to my palette. Pull, lift. Pull, lift. And what that creates is this rounded corner at one side of the brush. And on the palette, I bring that nice and close on the palette, you can actually see it's creating a bush shape here. So I've pulled through and lift, pull through and lift, and it creates a bush on the palette. Once you've got a bush on the palette, you're going to have a bush on the end of your brush as well, and it's with this rounded edge. So we take this rounded edge and we start at the base of where we want our bush to be, because that's going to be the darkest, and as we work upwards it will get lighter and lighter. So if we start here, we press and flex upwards. And we're not doing this, that's too much pressure. We're just pushing and flexing. Thinking about shape and form. And as I come upwards, maybe my bushes are getting further away, so they're going to get lighter. I'll just reload the brush, and I can bring another bush in front of that one. So I've got a darker bush here. Down here, doesn't matter, this can be any colour. This, you know, this you put on with the shoe, doesn't really matter. All we're interested in, a bit like our mountains, are these top spiky edges that look like leaves. And you get those from just flexing and loading your brush correctly. So, with that done, now you need a lot of paint to do the highlights on this. So what we're going to do is grab some liquid white. Pardon my head in front of everything. So I'm going to take this old dirty brush. I'll not be lazy for you guys. I'll do a clean brush. It'll make life easier for you. Where we go? I'm just trying to find a clean 2-inch brush. There we go. Right, I'm going to dip into some liquid white. And when I say dip in, I mean this amount of paint. Okay? Fair amount of paint there. I'm just going to splat it onto my palette. So I've still got a load in my brush. Now, I'm going to come through this green and yellow. I've still got some green and yellow on here. And I'm going to load a huge amount. Again, loading in one direction. Pull through. So pull through. Lift, pull through, lift, pull through, lift. And again, I'm creating this bush on the palette. If the bush is on the palette, I'm going to have a bush on the end of my brush. Pull through, lift, pull through, lift. So I've got a huge amount of paint on the end of my brush. Huge amount. And that's going to be my highlight colour. I might just brighten it up a bit so you can see it a bit easier on the footage. So I'm going to grab some more yellow ochre. Now remember, the yellow ochre is already fairly thin. It's already a highlight colour, so it's already thinned for us. So that should make life a bit easier. So again, I've got that green on there anyway. I'm just going to come through some of that yellow ochre as well. So I've got a huge amount of colour on here. Start with the bush that's furthest away. And you want to come just higher than the edge of the filigree. And you want to touch and flex. Just touch and push upwards. I'm not pressing hard. Not pressing hard at all. So there's my first bush. Coming to just the yellow this time. Maybe a bit of that liquid white just to change the colour slightly. I want to bring a bush in front of it, so just above where that bush is, and I'm going to bring a bush straight in front of that one I've just done. And as you come to the base of the bush, you press lighter and it creates automatic shadows for you. Now if you wanted to change the flavour a bit, you can keep that dirty brush, but you may want to grab some bright red. So we'll put some red over here. Now red will dull. It will create, if you mix red and green, it will create a brown. But because we've got some yellow on our brush as well, we should get an orangey, a nice autumny orangey colour. So again, pulling it through in one direction, lift, create that little bush. Again, we've got this bush here, so we can come in and we can just tap that bush in place. Because we've started at the top and worked downwards, it's picked up the darker colour and it's created shadow for us. This area is brighter, the bottom areas are darker. So if I really wanted to push these bushes back, I can come into my pure liquid white now. So I've changed the colour on the brush again, pure liquid white. And here, maybe I want to bring another bush in and just push that red bush backwards more. So now I've started to create four bushes, and all that's separating it are these shadowy colours in here. And again, what you might want to do, grab yourself your knife and you can come in here and you can scratch in leaves and twigs and whatever. And again, it creates another layer. It pushes things back, brings things forwards. These lines here are clearly behind this bush. This bit here clearly in front of this bush. And you can start creating whole different planes in your picture just by scratching. So again, it's very easy to do, but it's how you load your brush is what will give you the effects you're after. Now, if I wanted some grass coming off here, I could come back to my dark 1-inch brush, load up some of that dark colour. And this time I'm loading it almost like I did the fan brush. So I'm pulling it through and sharpening it. So there's not a huge amount of paint on there, but there's enough just to bring those bristles together. And now it's just tap. I can just tap and I can bring in just some dark land here for these bushes. So we've just got some dark grassy land coming out here. Just like so. That's fine. Come back to our brush that's got our other colours on it. Where are we? I've lost the camera. There we are. So we come back to our other brush that's got our other colours on it. Come into the green. Now this is already thin paint on here, so maybe come into some of that dark as well. And because it's got blue in, because I've got green on here anyway, I've got a nice dark highlight colour. And again, a lot of paint on there. And now I can come in and I can tap just above the edge of this dark colour and I can work in highlights in here. Now notice I'm not covering all of the dark. Notice here I've left areas that are dark, and that's creating shadow. It's creating depth and distance on this piece of land. Change the flavour slightly. and we'll start working on another piece here. And the more you tap, the more it will pick up those dark colours underneath and create light and shadow for you. So we can start creating land coming out here. And if you really wanted to create some sunlight coming through here, you can grab yourself some cadmium yellow. Excuse me while I just squeeze them out. I've had my tube of cadmium yellow quite a while, so it's dried a bit on me. That same old dirty brush, we can come into that cad yellow. Maybe just a little bit more liquid white. We'll just bring that out here. Right, so we've kept this roughly the same colours that we've been using, but we've now brightened it considerably and thinned it even more. So now we can come in and we can tap that on. And that can just highlight some of this and make it look like the sun zipping through here and just catching some of these pieces. Doesn't need to do much, you don't need to overdo it. If you wanted to, you could come just straight in with liquid white and just tap in liquid white on the end of your brush. So all I've done, got liquid white, just tap that into the end of the brush. And if you keep into that liquid white, you can actually make it look like maybe there's some flowers sat out on here, way off in the distance. So there they are. Maybe some daisies or something sat right out here on the edge. And it's just being ever so gentle. But always following the lay of the land, always following the direction the land is coming. Once you've done that, you just want to blend the land together a bit more. So we'll come back and create our bush again. And maybe here we can just put a little bush, tap in, just bring the feet of some of these down onto the land, blend it all together a bit more. There we go. And you can carry on for ages, it doesn't matter. You can carry on for days and days, keep doing that. Maybe you want to bring in a tree trunk or whatever. But you can just carry on doing that as much as you want to. So evergreens, bushes, I think we've got those licked. They're not a problem at all. Let's do a big tree. Let's do a group of big trees. We've got our same old dirty old brush, dark colour. Load it basically the same way we've been loading to do our bushes. So pull through, flex that. So we want round section upwards. We're going to have a big old tree here. So we're going to start at the bottom and just put in some bushes down here. And then as we work up, we're going to start thinking about the shape and form of the tree. Maybe it's going to come out here, maybe here a bit. And again, it's going to get darker towards the bottom. Down here we've got bushes and land that's going to come out. Maybe we'll tap some land out here. So this is going to be dark land down here. But this is forming our tree. Up here is our tree. We've decided we're going to have branches coming out. It's going to be a round tree type thing. So this is our tree. We started at the bottom, so the shadow is all at the bottom. As we work up, more light is coming from the rear of the tree, so we're getting more light through the tree here. It does it automatically for you. It's why we put liquid white on the canvas, etc., etc. Let me just grab, doesn't really matter what I grab here, but what I'm going to grab is a liner brush. We'll thin, put a lot of thinners on the liner brush. We're going to come into our dark colour and we're going to thin that down. So this is going to be what we're going to paint the tree trunks with. So we're just going to put some limbs and branches and stuff in here. You want to thin it down until it's just starting to run. And then roll your brush through it. And it should just start to run. Now, how you want to paint trunks is entirely up to you. I like to start at the bottom, press hard, and then wiggle my way up to a finer line. Some people will find it easier to start at the top. Some people will find it easier to start at the bottom. I normally start at the bottom and then work upwards. This is a fairly thick old liner brush, but it'll do the job. And doing tree trunks is down to you. You put as few limbs and everything in here as you want, and you put as many trees in here as you want. You know, this could be a little stand of tree, a little copse of trees. It could be anything. Everything is different depending on how we see it. So I'm just going to drop some things in here. Most of these will be covered up. Not going to see most of them. Maybe flick up a few bits just back here just to make it look like we've got some more stuff growing off in the background here. Doesn't really matter. We'll just put some indications of things living way off here in the distance. Like I say, most of them will be covered up, some of them won't, some of them will. Maybe this is an old dead tree set out the side here. Doesn't matter. Maybe down here, I don't know, maybe there's a fence. We'll put a fence in, just there. Doesn't matter. What we've got, in essence, is the background of our trees done. We've got dark, now we can start to put highlights on, we can start to create light. We're going to use this old brush again because we've got all our highlight colours here. We've got loads of colours here we can use. I tell you what, we'll use this brush still. We'll come into some liquid white again because everything has dried out slightly. And we'll just come in, pull through one direction, same as we did with the bush. And we're ready. So up here, you need to start thinking about how the limbs are going to form the tree. It's not just going to be one big section, so each limb is going to have its own little bush at the end. That's how you need to start thinking of trees. So if this section here is a limb, I've got a branch coming off here, so this is going to be a limb. So rounded corner of the brush upwards, and I'm just going to highlight that limb. Slightly different colour, slight colour change. Think where the next limb is going to be. Maybe there's going to be one up here. And highlight that one. Now I'm not covering up everything. It's not a question of coming in here and thinking, right, I need to highlight absolutely everything. There's no need to. Maybe I've got another limb here. There's no need to highlight everything. You can see through trees. Trees have light coming through them all the time. Because of that, you don't need to highlight everything. So you're creating this effect of bushes on a tree trunk. That's in essence all you're doing. You're creating bushes on a tree trunk. Maybe here. We'll just have another bit. So it's as simple as that. Now down the bottom here, I'm just going to clean this brush. Pardon my head. So the top of this tree will have quite far away in the distance there. We're going to grab some more cadmium yellow. Like so. And when I can find it, some sap green. We'll put some yellow ochre on as well. So we've got our main highlight colours here. Now I've already got, there's probably some thinners left on the brush here, so I can come through these colours and create a fairly thin colour straight away. And again, pull through, lift off, pull through, lift off. You see that? Pull through, lift off. So I'm creating a bush on here, and I've got a bush here. So this part of the tree is further back, so maybe the bushes need to come forward a bit. So decide where this bush is going to live. And we'll put a bush there. And because it's brighter, because we've used brighter colours, and we've made it more clear, it pushes these rear trees backwards. Change the colour slightly, so we'll come into some of the green. Again, pull through. Lift off, pull through, lift off. We're going to have a bush on the brush. I'm going to leave this dark bit here. I'm going to bring a bush distinctly in front of it. So now it's creating that. I can be a bit more gentle. I can come down here and along the edge by the fence. I can put some grassy little bits down here. Maybe a bush just there. Like so. Turn the brush sideways. Come back into my green. So I'm loading it sideways now. And tap. Now again, I'm creating grass on the palette by tapping. So that's the same thing I'm going to do. I'm going to have grass on the end of the brush. So now I can come in here and I can create a grassy meadow at the bottom of this, or just somewhere where all these trees are sitting out being quite happy. The more you tap, the more this will pick up colour, the smoother it will become. So there, you know, now we've got depth and distance. We've got a bush in front, we've got bushes here, the trees are further away. If we really wanted to really push the distance in here, we can get our filbert brush. Let's grab our filbert brush. Here's our filbert brush. Gonna come into that dark. Load a lot of dark colour on our filbert brush. Okay, so a load of dark on our filbert brush. Maybe, I don't know, maybe just here. We're going to have a big old tree. We're going to cut through everything. And it's going to live just there. And maybe it's got an old foot comes out one direction or the other. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter where it goes even. That's our big old tree. Just widen it up at the bottom there. Gone up there a bit more. Being a bit more gentle, maybe he's got a branch that lives off here. I'll give him a branch or two. Maybe he can have another old wiggly old branch that comes off this side. Doesn't matter. Goes off. No, we don't mind where that goes, it just heads off somewhere. So we've added another layer in here. Now what you can do with this one, we'll grab some titanium white, he says, when he can find it. We'll just put that here. So grab some titanium white, we'll just flatten that out. We'll grab some of our dark colour, we'll put that in there. We'll just pull it out, nice and flat. Okay, so titanium white and some of that dark colour. Cut a small roll of paint onto the end of your knife. Decide where your light source is coming from. I'm going to have it come this way. I'm just going to pick up the edge of that tree and just tap. All I'm doing is tapping. Turn the knife, follow the angle of the tree. Just tapping. The more you tap, more colour will come off your knife, but also the more it will mix with the dark colour already on the canvas. So you'll start to be able to form highlights, but also some texture. Literally all we're doing is tapping. If things start to get a bit too bright, grab some of your dark colour. So grab our dark colour, pull that out flat. Get your little roll of paint and come back on the other side and just tap that in. So we're working dark and light against each other all the time. So all the time dark and light. And it's adding texture to this tree as well, you know, it's going to make it feel like bark. People will be able to come up to your picture and touch it, and it will actually feel like bark. So we're just adding darkness and light, just to create some texture there. Then we can grab our script liner brush again. Make sure we've got some nice thin colour. We've already got some up here. Bring it to a nice point, and then off here you can start dragging all these extra little limbs, and you can go on for however long you want to go on for doing this. This is, you know, some people are quite happy just to have a few limbs, some people like a lot. It's all subjective. It's how you want your tree to look. Just going to be a big old tree sat here. He's been here some years now. Now if you have trouble letting this paint flow over the highlights we've already got here, then you need to make it thinner. So add more thinners or liquid white and just thin it down. Down the bottom here we might want to grab some of this yellow and green. Again, I've thinned this paint down, so I've got a nice thin paint and I can flick in some little tufts of grass or whatever down by its feet here. Maybe over here by the fence we can have some. Doesn't matter. Just flick some bits in, give it a bit more depth and distance. And if we thin down the white, so if we thin down our white a lot, you can either thin this down or you can use liquid white. Liquid white is sometimes easier to do. We'll try it with just thin colour today. Put some right on the end of the brush, and just here you can come in and you can create flowers. And they're just 1, 2, 3, 4. All it is, just 4 spots. 1, 2, 3. If you want a smaller one, move the spots closer together. If you want to make it slightly bigger, move them further apart. And just, you know, have fun. If you want to give the indication of some that are open, you can just dab. You don't want them all out here, but, you know, you can just put an indication in there. Come back into the yellow. And each open flower can have just a little spot of yellow in the middle. And you can even grab the bottom of this white and just pull it down, and it makes it look like they're sat out there on their stems. Just like so. But it all adds depth and distance into your scene. And just that little area there, We've got background trees, we've got foreground trees. The little poppies or the little daisies down here are adding another depth and layer into the image. So it makes it stand out even more. Good. We're happy with that. What we're going to have over here? I don't know what we're going to have over here. I'll tell you what we'll have over here. Start with our dark colour. Now we've not got a lot of dark colour here, but we're just going to put in an indication of some trees. Now because we haven't got a lot of dark colour, you can see through, you know, these aren't really harsh. So these are just indications of trees that are going to live way off in the distance. Because they're just literally, you can almost see through them. Okay? From there, we're going to grab our dark 2-inch brush and come into our dark colour. Not a lot of colour, but we're just going to tap onto here. So up here, maybe you want to start hinting at trees, and all I'm doing is thinking where some of these distant limbs might live, and I'm just tapping them in. I'm not filling up all this background area, all I'm doing is tapping in an indication of where I think limbs might be, way back here in the distance. Maybe some angle downwards, I don't know, doesn't really matter. Not pressing hard, just tapping. So we've got background trees now. We're going to come into some of our other colours. We've got a load of dirty old colours here on the canvas, we're going to use them all. Just come in and tap. And we can start to put some colour into these. We're still using that same old dirty brush, reload regularly. And you can just start putting colour way back in the distance here. And you want to work on the top edges of these. Leave the bottom edges alone, because there's going to be shadow. Even way back off in the distance like this, there's going to be shadow living back here. So this is just, you're figuring out depth and distance. Maybe some are a bit brighter than others. So we've got yellows here, we've got reds. Maybe I want to bring this one out a bit more, so I'll just bring that forward just by putting a bit more highlight onto it. So now we've got some trees way off in the distance there. Hardly any definition to them. They're just quite happily lurking off in the distance. Now we're going to come in and get a lot of black on our brush. Now we can come in and go, right, okay, here's a foreground tree. So this tree is living a lot closer. Maybe we'll have another one. Maybe we'll have another one there. Because it's darker, it's got more definition, it's closer to us. We'll have another one. We'll have another one here. And it doesn't matter that we're losing our background. The background is there. We know it's there. It's given our painting depth and distance. So we've now got trees in the foreground as well. I think we'll have these as birch trees. So what we'll do, we'll grab our white, pull it out flat, pull a roll of colour onto the end of the knife. And what you do is you touch and pull around. So pull around, pull down and up, down and up. And it's almost like painting a mountain. You want the paint to break. And it creates a lovely birch tree look. So you want the paint to break. You want to pull round and let the paint break. So it's only a very slight touch. And just pull round. It's probably the easiest trees to do. literally with a little down, little down pull, and then an up pull. If that makes sense. If some aren't quite light enough on the edge, just come back and do it again. And you can really make these really stand out against that background colour. So once you've done that, you might want to come and get some of your dark colour. Grab that and come back the other way. So you're doing dark and you're doing it the other way. And that will start to create texture on your trees. So it's about how you load the knife, how you start to use it. I'll just finish off this last one. There. Okay, so with that done, let's grab another liner brush. If I can find one in the brush pot. Never find one when you're looking for it. There it is. Okay, so we'll grab our liner brush. A lot of thinners on here, and we'll wet our dark colour up again. So we've got a lovely thin dark colour. Twist the liner brush to get a lot of paint on it. And now you can come through and you can start putting limbs on all of these. And again, it's how you want them to look. These are your trees, so you have them. You have limbs in front or behind. You put them wherever you want. Maybe this tree is distinctly in front of the tree behind it there. So some of its limbs are going to come over. This tree in the background is behind this foreground tree, so that can stay there. And you can just put however many limbs you want. Just drop some on this one so it doesn't feel left out. They moan at you if they get left out. Tell you off. There, that'll do it. That'll do it. So we've got some fir trees out there. Good. We might want to give these a really nice autumnal look. So what we're going to do is grab our cadmium yellow. We've already got some cad yellow on the palette here anyway. So we'll grab some cad yellow, and we'll also grab a little bit of bright red. And I want to thin this colour down a bit, so I'm going to grab a fan brush and just dip into thinners. So I've just dipped a tiny bit of thinners in there. Let me just clean the fan brush. Beat it slightly, and probably what I've got left on there will be enough. So I'm going to thin first this cad yellow down and tap into it. Pull it out and tap. Then come into the red and tap into that as well. So I've now got a mixture of red. Maybe come into the brown or the green, just to dull it slightly. We don't want it mega garish like the trees on fire, but we just want to dull it slightly. So now we've got a thin colour, and because we're tapping, we've got a leaf shape on our palette, so we'll have a leaf shape on our brush. Now you can come in and you can say, right, I'm going to have some leaves here. If it's not bright enough, I'm going to brighten it up a bit just so you guys can see it. and just think about shape and form of these. So we're just creating these lovely hangy leaves. You don't want to overdo it. Maybe come into a little bit of liquid white, and that will just brighten this up a bit. So I've just got that liquid white tapped into my palette again. It's thinned the paint, but also brightened it up a bit. So now I can just tap some in. And bring some, don't be afraid, to bring some over the limbs, over the trees. Don't be scared of that. It's going to give depth and distance. So don't be scared to bring it over your other trees here. Not going to do any harm. All it's going to do is give depth and distance. Maybe down here there's a couple of little branches hanging out. Maybe this side. Like so. So now we've created that. We'll just finish this off because I'm enjoying myself. I'm just going to finish this off a bit. So I'll grab old dirty old brush. Down the bottom here, we'll just knock some bushes in. So just push some bushes in there. Like so. Grab our dirty old 2-inch brush that we've been highlighting with. Come into a little liquid white. So we're coming to liquid white again, and we're coming to our highlight colours. We've got some lovely colours over here now. So we'll grab some of those, some nice reds. Pull through, lift up. Pull through, lift up. Turn the brush upwards. Put a big old firecracker of a bush in there. Oh yeah, I like that one. Come into this greeny colour. Maybe have another one here. Like so. And what we'll do is we'll brighten up this red. That out on the end here. Like so. Grab our knife, we can scratch into here. Like so. So there we go. That's, you know, we've done bushes, we've done fir trees up top here. You've got distant trees and then bringing them forwards with layered trees and everything like that. And we've also done more distant trees off in the background here. And it's just about learning when you need a thinner colour or when you need a thicker colour, and just learning how to load your knife and how to load your brush and how to apply it to the canvas. So I hope that's been helpful for you. As per normal, if you've got any questions, if you've got any hints or anything you want me to do or anything you want me to pick up on, just drop me a line. You know, like me, I'm enjoying doing these videos. So if you subscribe, I'm sure to do some more. And happy painting, and I'll see you next time.